سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله
تأمينه تأمين الملائكة غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. This hadith is narrated by Abi Hurairah رضي الله عنه عبد الرحمن بن صخر رضي الله عنه. He says Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says when the Imam makes Ameen, ta'ammana is to say Ameen. Idha ammana al-Imam, when the Imam makes Ameen, fa'amminu, you should also say Ameen. The mas'ala of Ameen is in Surah Al-Fatiha, of course, when the Imam says, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Ta'ameen is to say Ameen. This Ameen comes in three different alfaz. The first lafz, which is the most popular, is with a mad, right? With a mad and without a shadd. Ameen. The second lafz is qasr. Ameen. Right? The third lafz is with a mad and a shadd. Ameen. How many alfaz? Three alfaz. This lafz Ameen comes from qawluhu ta'ala in Surah Al-Ma'idah, wa la ameen al-bayt al-harama yabtaghuna fadlan min rabbihim. Amina. Ameen means they seek to go. Ameen and Bayt al-Haram, they seek to go to the Holy House. So, Ameena, this is what they want. Alright? So when we say Ameena, the taqdeer is Nahnu Ameena Dhalika. We also want that. What do we want? What the Imam said in Surah Al-Fatiha. Ihdina al-sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim wa ladh-dhallin. So we say, Ameen. Ya'ni, nahnu ameena dhalika. We also intend that. That's what we intend. That is our dua. The person who says, Ameen, is the same as a person who makes dua. If someone makes dua and the other people say Ameen, they're also making dua. And the dalil is... Yeah, but what is the dalil in the Quran that a person who says Ameen is like a person who is making dua? Sheikh Sulaiman. In Surah Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ مُوسَى, and Musa said, رَبَّنَا, O Allah, إِنَّكَ آتَيْتَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَأَهُ زِينَةً وَأَمْوَالًا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. You're the one who gave Fir'aun and his ministers all this wealth in the world. رَبَّنَا لِيُضِلُّ عَن سَبِيلِكَ. My Lord, they're using this to drive people away from your path. رَبَّنَا طُمِسْ عَلَىٰ أَمْوَالِهِمْ وَاشْتُطْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا. Oh Allah, harden their hearts. فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا, so that they don't believe. حَتَّى يَرَوْا الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمِ, until they see a grievous punishment. Who's making the dua? Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then Allah says, قَدْ أُجِيبَتْ دَعْوَتُكُمَا. The dua of you two, دَعْوَتُكُمَا, you two, the dua you make, قَدْ أُجِيبَ, has been answered. Which two? Allah said, وَقَالَ مُوسَى, And Musa said, the one making dua is Musa, but which two? Musa and? But how is Harun making dua when Allah said, وَقَالَ Musa, and Musa said? Because Harun was saying, Amin. Therefore the dua is the dua of Musa and Harun. So by saying Amin, it's as good as making the dua as well. So the mas'ala that we need to tackle concerning the Amin is, first we consider, and I'm hopeful that we all know these phrases by now, we consider the Munfarid. What is a Munfarid? Munfarid is the one who prays on his own. Okay, then who do we consider? The Ma'mum. Okay, thirdly, who do we consider? The Imam. Is there any other situation in Salah apart from Munfarid, Imam and Ma'mum? Is there another situation in Salah? You pray either as a Munfarid, or you pray as a Ma'mum, or you pray as an Imam. It doesn't go outside these three. Alright? So the Munfarid. Is the Munfarid supposed to say Amin? Yes, the Munfarid is supposed to say Amin. He says Amin silently. Alright? The Munfarid, the one praying alone, says Amin silently. The Ma'mum, or maybe let's go to the Imam. Does the Imam say Amin? Silently or loudly? What's the dalil? So should he say it loudly or silently? And some says? Who says? The Imam. Now, Abu Hanifa and one qawl of Imam Malik is that the Imam should say it silently. Abu Hanifa and one qawl of Malik, when I say one qawl, it means he has another opinion. Alright? One qawl of Malik is that the Imam should say Amin silently. So in short, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. The Ma'mumi, Amin. And the Imam, Amin. Alright? That is the qawl of Abu Hanifa and one qawl of Malik. Imam Shafi'i and Ata' bin Abi Rabah. Ata' bin Abi Rabah took from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. And Ahmad ibn Hanbal said the Imam is supposed to say the Ameen loudly. Because qawluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man waqafa ta'minuhu ta'min al malaika. The one whose Ameen is going to coincide with the Ameen of the Malaika, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. The Imam should not be left out of this problem. It's a problem, isn't it? It's an excellence, isn't it? To say Ameen and say the Ameen together with the Malaika. So the Imam says, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Ameen. Alright? But the Imam should not say, he shouldn't say, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ. Ameen. No. He should pause. He should rest a little bit. Then say Ameen, so that people should not think Ameen is part of Surah Al-Fatiha. There's supposed to be istira'a between walabbalin and Ameen. Are we together? Fine. Before I finish this mas'ala of Okay, very quickly. What about outside Salah? If someone reads Surah Al-Fatiha, should we say Ameen if it's not in Salah?
Yes.
It's a dua. The Surah Al-Fatiha is a surah of the Quran. Alright? And there's no dalil that says when Surah Al-Fatiha is read, people should say Ameen. The dalil is in Salah. When the Imam says wala dalil, say amin. There's no dalil outside salah. Islam is not like that. You get my point. In Islam, everything has to have dalil. No, we didn't say if a man is making dua. I said if someone is reading Surah Al-Fatiha outside Salah, should we say Ameen when he finishes? It's different. If he's making dua, you'll be saying Ameen all the way. It's not just at the end. If the Fatiha is a dua, when he says Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you'll be saying Ameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Ameen. Malik Yawm Al-Din, Ameen. This is a different masala altogether. I'm talking about Ameen at the end of Surah Al-Fatiha. There's no dalil for that. The dalil is in Salah. Is there Ameen in the Mus'haf after Walad Dhalin? Is there Ameen in the Mus'haf? So what? Why say something which Rasulullah didn't say you should say? There's no dalil, right? But in Salah, is there dalil? Yeah, because he said if your ta'meen is going to coincide with the ta'meen of the malaika, this is in Salah. And I want to share a secret with you. SubhanAllah, this is why if you can pray in the jama'ah, this is a great problem. To always get this excellence of saying Ameen together with the malaika, I think that's a wonderful problem. It's a wonderful problem. And the secret, it's why Salah in the jama'ah is 27 times better than Salah alone, because of this problem. Of saying Ameen with the malaika. And I tell you what, it's why an imam is a person to be respected. Because someone who says Walad Dhalin and even the malaika say Ameen is someone of some standing in the society. If the angels, he says Walad Dhalin and the angels say Ameen, then an imam is an important person. Alhamdulillah. And some scholars say that's why there's a difference between salah, silent salah in the jama'ah and loud salah in the jama'ah. Loud salah in the jama'ah has more power than silent salah in the jama'ah. Dhuhr in the jama'ah is not the same as Isha in the jama'ah. Isha in the jama'ah has more reward than dhuhr in the jama'ah. Because in Isha you get to express Ameen with the malaika. And in that salah, you also get the chance to listen to Quran and Ushur. It's just different. It's not the same as Dhuhr. Alhamdulillah, it's a good thing to pray in the jama'ah. But the problem of a salah in which Quran is recited loudly in the jama'ah cannot be
ignored. We'll continue. E poi che sei in fa, buon se tu venai mani.